Pooja and my young friends and all members of your team, this side and this side. You know, we have heard a scintillating presentation on development plan 2034. The plan had already been prepared and it met with opposition criticism from so many quarters. The government was compelled to get it re-examined, revised, and the government couldn't have found a better person than Dr. Ramanath Jha for heading this revision effort. And what we have seen, it may not be absolutely perfect, and he himself says that, you know, it is open to suggestions, but what we have seen in the course of the past 2.5 hours, friends, is very, very encouraging. I recall here seeing on Twitter a couple of days back a tweet by Sadiq Khan, the mayor of London. Mayor of London posted a picture of himself addressing the citizens of Mumbai, citizens of London, different stakeholders, and the program was called the mayor participating, or the mayor giving a State of London lecture. The State of London lecture given by the mayor of the city. Now, have we ever heard the mayor of Mumbai giving a State of Mumbai lecture? Have you ever heard the mayor of Mumbai interacting with the citizens of Mumbai, with the students of Mumbai, with the entrepreneurs of Mumbai, with NGOs of Mumbai on the future development of the city? You know, the way you were presenting, you need to be the Sadiq Khan of Mumbai, Ramanath Jha. Friends, you know, I was reading your own preface to this, and you know, you have identified quite rightly why the previous DPs were not implemented effectively. 1964, 1991, and now we have a huge overload of tasks that were not implemented. But why were they not implemented? Finance, of course, is a constraint that you have identified. But one thing that you have not identified, and one cannot expect you to identify, being a civil servant and this being a government document, is bad governance. If the previous development plans were not implemented properly, it is primarily bad governance and bad politics that Mumbai has been suffering from. So bad politics is the elephant in the room. Without discussing, you know, we cannot expect Ramanath Jha to comment on that. But friends, you are all citizens, we are citizens, we are not in government. But we must discuss, if we want to make Mumbai a city for all, then we must address the most important constraint, and that is the kind of politics that this city has become victim to. We must compliment Dr. Ramanath Jha for presenting a vision, a city for all, a happy city for all. And that point that you mentioned is very important. In the end, we all want to live happy lives. And unless the city aspires to provide, you know, the city cannot ensure happiness, but the city can facilitate a more happy life for more and more people. A livable city with a very high standard of life, high quality of life for all citizens, an innovative Mumbai, and it was so refreshing for us to see how Dr. Jha and his team have introduced some innovations. Parking authority, a GIS monitoring of all the parking places so that the scarce space is utilized by all in the best possible manner. It was very refreshing again to see a major thrust on housing, affordable housing, which is a critical requirement for a majority of Mumbaikars, including the upper middle class Mumbaikars. Today it has become so unaffordable that only the rich can buy a house. This must change. Another innovation for which we heartily congratulate you is the focus on arts and culture. Mumbai has neglected arts and culture to its own detriment. This must be corrected. The Observer Research Foundation, friends, is soon coming out. We have been working on a culture policy, arts and culture policy for Mumbai, and I was very happy to see that you have provided spaces for making Mumbai vibrant in terms of arts and culture. Because our cities in India, we have one of the most artistic cultural heritage in the world, but unfortunately our urbanization is making it difficult for more and more people to either participate in artistic cultural activities or to contribute. This must change. Our ideal should be that every single citizen of Mumbai should be benefited by the arts and cultural life of the city and also to participate, because that's the only way we can enrich our own lives and also have some happiness. You mentioned another innovation, institutional area. Mumbai, I was telling Dr. Jha before we came here, in decades we have not provided for any public space for creating new institutions of national or international standard. We don't have a single world-class institution that we have built. The ones that were built, TISS, TIFR, IIT, these are all decades ago. And therefore, we must compliment you for providing, I don't know whether it's adequate, but certainly large enough space for institutions. Friends, look at Delhi. Delhi has institutional areas. New Delhi has, newer areas of Delhi have, and as a result, there are so many institutions that have come up, which are vital for India, and Mumbai has gone down enormously in this respect, and therefore, if you create space, the citizens of Mumbai, the entrepreneurs of Mumbai, the professionals of Mumbai, they'll all come together to build new institutions. And one of the institutions that we certainly should build is, as we discussed, a university, a new university, a world-class university for sustainable urbanization. India needs it badly. We are urbanizing so very rapidly. Our institutions are not really capable of tackling the challenges of urbanization. We need more and more well-educated, well-qualified, well-trained people, and Mumbai should therefore come together and establish. We have, at ORF, we have discussed this matter with CIDCO. If we all come together, it can happen. Friends, what made me very happy with this interaction is that this is participative democracy at its best. Democracy is not elective democracy alone. Unfortunately, it has been so. Our political parties and our elected representatives, and we all know how they get elected, they have closed the doors for citizens to participate in issues that concern their lives. And therefore, we must compliment the Municipal Commissioner, Shri Ajoy Mehta, with whom my colleagues Saili and Gautam and Dhaval Desai, they all interacted. And now we have this opportunity. of interaction which has been so fruitful for all of us. And I really wonder, I want to know, have you had a similar interaction with the political parties, with their karyakartas, with Nagar Sevaks?
Not in this great detail, but I have made a presentation to all the important representatives and groups.
Yeah.
And I had to take them along.
Yeah, we need more and more. More participation. All of us will have a greater stake in its implementation. You mentioned that land is a constraint. You know, I would like to suggest you also gave a chart that gave information about the land that Mumbai has, Tokyo, New York, etc., etc. And we have, in terms of size, we are lowest. But the difference between 1964 and 1991 is that now Mumbai is not just Greater Mumbai. Greater, you know, Mumbai, in my opinion, friends, is Mahamumbai. It is metropolitan region of Mumbai, which is 10 times the size of Mumbai. If Mumbai is, that is under MCGM or BMC, is 470 square meters, MMR is 4,300 square meters. 10 times larger. Now we are creating infrastructure connectivity all over MMR. As your own DP says, 60% of the people who work in MCGM area, they come from places outside MCGM. So why don't we conceptually think of Maha Mumbai, that is metropolitan Mumbai, as the planning area? The time has come. You know, we cannot have Thane doing its own plan, Dombivli doing its own plan, Kalyan Dombivli, that is, and other corporations doing their own plans. No, we need to integrate. And the time has come, taking all the great ideas that you have introduced in this DP and also taking into account their needs, and of course their needs are our needs, making a plan for the entire MMR. And it should not be left to MMRDA, because MMRDA is not a representative body. BMC is a representative body. We all must have a say as citizens in how MMR is going to be developed. So it's a point for your consideration and for the consideration of others. Lastly, you know, you have very rightly pointed out that economy, environment, equity, the three E's, must be balanced. Absolutely right. But we should go beyond balancing to how we can enhance and augment all three. Because if we think of balancing, then we want to just see what can be done within the existing constraints. No, we must break constraints and think of how we can enhance, augment, enrich the economy, environment, and make Mumbai a more equitable city and show the way for a more equitable India. So, thank you, friends. It's been a wonderful interaction for all of you and all of us at the Observer Research Foundation. The Observer Research Foundation's motto is ideas and action for better India. And as Gautam said right at the beginning, you know, all politics is local. Similarly, all patriotism is also local. We must become Mumbai patriots. If we are better Mumbai patriots, we become better Indian patriots. So let's create a better Mumbai and show the way for a better India. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Kulkarni.